Beauty pageants, whether you rate them or hate them, they're still quite popular in our Pacific communities.
Popular indeed. This week it's time for the Ta'ahines from the Friendly Islands of Tonga to compete for this year's Miss Tonga New Zealand crown. John Pulu has the lowdown on this year's pageant.
It's the time of the year when the prettiful girls from the Kingdom of Tonga come out to play. Six stunning girls compete throughout not one, not two, but three nights of intense competition, all fighting for the glory and the crown of Miss Tonga New Zealand.
It's a great excuse for all the Tongan communities here in New Zealand, especially Auckland, to get together, support their girls. Over the course of these last three nights, a lot of them have been coming, a lot of them have been paying, they've been putting money towards the girls, and all this money goes back to the Heilala Festival, goes back to Tonga.
Malolele, I'm here at the opening night where the contestants will be competing in the first two categories, which is the traditional Tongan attire and sarong wear. Oh yeah, where? It's getting hot in here, or is it just me? It's just me, isn't it?
Here are the gorgeous foi loles you all want to see.
My name is Adeline Lilac Glatu. I'm from Fasmoyafi Nukualofa.
Kuhingoa ko Angela Naa. Kuhuhao me lapahalo to mua vavao.
My name is Kapuatu Kongfou Tumayao. I'm from Longamapu and Kalamotua.
Hi, my name is Joan Ikatonga Corbett. My family's from Kolovai.
My name is Makalita Poalofa Feki. I come from Halonga Vavao.
My name is Galolaine Payne Lopatoi. I'm 22 years old and I'm from Ha'apai, Pasimoyafi Nukalofa.
For many of these lovely ladies, this pageant is about getting closer to their Tongan roots.
I think the whole point of doing this pageant thing is to represent where you're from and who you are.
I never done that in my whole life. That was my first time ever.
You know how people think like half castes aren't really Tongan, but I think I'm pretty in touch with my culture, like a little bit more than I was before.
The thing I enjoyed most was the Ta'alunga night, just wearing the Tongan tradition Ta'alunga costume.
And as the girls do their best to embrace their culture and impress the crowd, only the judges will decide who gets the crown.
What I'm looking for in the Miss Tonga New Zealand is someone who's confident, resilient, and someone who has a firm recognition of their culture and identity.
We will be looking at how close the girls have the outfits that we traditionally have in Tonga, and how it fits in with today.
Knowing who you are, your identity as being Tongan, your culture, and know a lot about Tonga.
Tonight's winner will move on to compete for the crown of Miss Heilala in Tonga next week. But for now, the girls' crowning moment is when they hit the stage.
I never get up in front of people. I'm one of those on that distance that like standing up. I don't know, I can manage to stand up in front of everyone, but I did it.
I was stressing out a bit in the first night, but then I relaxed and enjoyed myself on the second night, which is what I'm going to do tonight. So I'm going to have fun.
Through this competition, I've taken a lot. And knowing that I can be strong and actually take that pressure, yeah, it showed that I can be a strong Tongan woman.
Now with the magic of TV, it's the final night, and it wouldn't be a royal event without a ball. With all the formalities out of the way, it all comes down to this.
Our Miss Tongan New Zealand for 2010. It goes to Kafo Atu Tule Maiao.
The Kingdom's just found an extra princess.
Congratulations, Kafo Atu, and all the best for next week.